Recently, a lot of people have been asking me how I use Raycast. So in this video, I'm going to show you what's in my Raycast, what extensions I have, which commands I use the most, which hotkeys I use, and so on. Let's jump right in. The number one thing that I use the most in Raycast is the clipboard history. I can actually trigger the clipboard history whenever I want by pressing Command Shift V. That's the hotkey assigned to it. And the reason I like clipboard history so much is because I know that in the past I've copied some things and I know that I can always find them in the history. So the last few YouTube videos that I've copied, I know that I can find them just by typing in YouTube, and here I can see the links to all of the videos. The cool thing about the history as well is that because I copy so many images, I can actually just filter here by images. Often when I copy an image, before I share that image with someone, I might want to edit it a little bit. So I can press Command K to annotate image, or I just press Command Shift A. And what that would do is open it up in CleanShot, where I can then go and start editing my image, and I can add some wallpaper, change the padding, and just use CleanShot the way I would normally use it, and you can annotate it and so on. Another command that I use very often is the search screenshots command. And I've got this assigned to Command Shift S. And this command basically looks up into different directories and it pulls in all the images and movies from these designated folders. So to see how these folders are, you can configure this command and you can add them here in preferences. In my case, every image and video that's in the desktop or in the CleanShot folder will show up in the search screenshots command. If you're not familiar with Raycast window management, it comes in with basically loads and loads of different commands that you can use to organize your windows. What I use the most very, very often is when I'm coding, I often want the browser on one side and the editor on the other. That way I can see them both at the same time. So I can quite quickly do that by using the hotkeys I've assigned to them. And if I need to make one of them full screen, then I can also do that and put it back. And if I want it slightly larger, I can also cycle through different widths. And I can also take, say, another window, and I can easily put it in the center of the screen, and I can easily change the size if I need to. For the commands that you don't really need hotkeys against because you don't use them that often, you can also just trigger them directly through Raycast using the first letter of the command. So say we have a command called almost maximize. So if I just type in AM, you can see it shows up here, almost maximize. I can press enter and it basically almost maximizes the window. So next up is floating notes. I've been using that since I first downloaded Raycast, but now I actually have the newest version, which we're still working on. As you can see, it's gonna look slightly different than how your floating notes look, but expect that in the new pro version. So I use floating notes as a brain dump for everything that I'm doing or things that I have to do. The good thing about floating notes is that I can very, very easily toggle it whenever I need to. In my case, I'm using Option N. In this floating notes, for example, I'm keeping a list of everything that I've done this week or things that I still have to do here this week, and then I can mark them as done when they're ready. I can also press Command P to then change the notes that I'm looking at. So here I have some other notes of, say, some scripts of videos that we did in the past. Another thing I use a lot is Quicklinks. If I open up the search Quicklinks command, you can see there are a bunch of Quicklinks here, and most of them actually live under the Raycast organization. So these are links that are shared between the whole team. And so if you have a Raycast team account, this is a great way to make sure that your entire team have access to specific links. In our case, we have links to our Notion documents and our linear boards and stuff like that. The cool thing about quick links is that they are surfaced through the root search. So we have a quick link here called 24 Raycast Tips. And this link is something we use often for whenever somebody just joined Raycast and they're asking on how they can use Raycast. then we can quickly share this tip. So if I press enter here, you see that it opens up that link that is just a Twitter thread with the tips. We can also press Command K and copy the actual link. So then you can share that link with someone. We've actually recorded a video on how you can make the most out of Quicklinks. So I'll leave a link up in the screen. Next up is AI commands. So that's something I use all the time. And if you're a Raycast Pro user, you should have access to built-in AI commands. One that I use a lot is, say for example, I want to make sure that this blog I've just written is well-written without any typos. Then I will just use the fix spelling and grammar command. And then AI will actually highlight the things that were wrong and fix it for me. So then I'll just paste that back in and now we're good to go. And another command that I've created myself is sometimes I might not remember the word that I'm after. So what I do, I will just replace that word with a little placeholder. I will open up Raycast and use the fill in the blank command. This is a custom AI command. And when I do that, then AI will give me 5 words that I can use in that gap. While we're on the topic of AI, then another thing that I use a lot is the AI chat. So this one, rather than being an AI command, it's basically a chat window. Just like ChatGPT, you can choose to use GPT 3.5 or GPT 4. And then here you can just start having a conversation with it as you normally would. And now another built-in command that I use all the time is the emoji picker. And I do that by pressing Command, Control, Space. And then here you see the Raycast emoji picker where I have some pinned emojis that I use often. And there's also the ones I use frequently. So here are the ones I use all the time. We also made a quick tip video about the emoji picker. So I'm gonna put that up on screen. Make sure to check that out as well. Let's talk about extensions. So as most people know, Raycast has an extensive extension store with over 1,000 extensions to choose from. And I'm gonna talk about the ones I use the most. And actually they happen to be up here in the menu bar. So here you can see GitHub. So this is the GitHub notification command. So the GitHub extension has a bunch of commands. One of them is the notification. So very quickly I can see if I have any notifications on GitHub. Then there is Spotify. I can actually search for anything on Spotify. So here we can say, let's say Miles Davis, and you can see here in the search, and from here we can start playing straight away. And that'll start playing up here. You can see that whatever's currently playing then shows up in my menu bar. So that's super handy. So then we have Linear, very similar to GitHub. Here I can keep up to date with any notifications from Linear. And using Raycast, we can also create issue directly from Raycast, which is super handy. You can see your assigned issues and anything that's on your Linear account, you can surface that directly through Raycast. The Color Picker extension is also another one that I use all the time. And I actually have a hotkey against this one, Command Option P. So the way this one works is when I press Command Option P, I get this little magnifying glass here where I can just go pick the color that I want. That copies it to the clipboard. So if I open my clipboard history now, you'll be able to see the color that we just copied. I also use the Zoom extension to quickly start a Zoom meeting. And this one is great because it basically opens up Zoom, copies the URL that you can share with someone straight away, and then you're ready to start your meeting. I also use the download YouTube video extension. So this one is handy. You can just put the URL of the video you want to download. So these are some of the top extensions that I use daily, and I'm gonna leave the links for them in the description below so you can install them yourself. Everything you've just seen is just the tip of the iceberg of everything that Raycast can do for you. These are just the features I use the most on a day-to-day basis. But I'm curious, how do you use Raycast? Are there any commands or extensions that you can't live without? We're planning on doing more videos like this, so if there's anyone that you'd like to see featured in these videos, leave a comment below and we'll try and make it happen.